A lot of smokers are turning to an alternative device to help kick the habit, and it's actually working for some users.
But some fear that it could become a trend for young kids. Talitha Vickers shares more about the pros and cons of vaping.
Vapor cigarettes. It's helping people get off of tobacco. Plug in, charge up, add flavored liquid, and vaporize. The tank holds the liquid that creates the vapor. The battery heats that liquid up. And we have over 100 different flavors you can choose to go into your tank.
The process is picking up steam among people like Mel Hill, looking for an alternative to smoking cigarettes.
I've been doing this about 2 weeks now, and I do not want a cigarette at all. Like, I smoked half a cigarette last week, and it made me sick.
These vapor cigarettes eliminate the 4,000 dangerous chemicals packed into traditional cigarettes. Instead, flavored liquid like bubblegum, cherry, or grape is mixed with varying degrees of nicotine to help kick the habit.
Typically, after a few weeks of using the 24 milligram, they'll cut down to 18. 18, they'll cut down to 12. 12, they'll cut down to 6, and then possibly down to 0.
I've been smoking for 15 years. And I've quit before for months at a time or a couple weeks at a time even. And this is the only thing that's worked so far because it makes me feel like I'm smoking a cigarette when I'm not.
Doctors are weighing in, saying although vaping is not as harmful as smoking cigarettes.
Inhaling a hot vapor with drugs in it is not good. There have not been enough studies to show that it can be effectively used to help people stop smoking.
Some parents are raising a red flag along with Attorney General Roy Cooper, saying the lure of flavored vapor could send the wrong message to children. Cooper says, quote, many of these products are misleading people, especially minors, into thinking they are a safe alternative to smoking cigarettes. We know there needs to be more research into the ingredients and effects of nicotine, and in the meantime, we'll continue to fight to protect our children. And for that very reason, Terry Moose has safeguards in place at Vapor Oasis in Winston-Salem.
We're very, very strict about who we sell to. And we do ask for ID. And we will not sell to anyone that is under 18 years of age. We're very, very strict about that.
Although not approved by the FDA, many users say vaping has proved to be the only alternative over the patch and gum to help kick the habit and improve their quality of life.
I cannot smoke at all anymore. I don't even like the smell of it. It's working. I don't smell anymore. I don't cough as much as I used to. Everything's starting to taste better. Food tastes different now.
That was Talitha Vickers reporting. Now, other states like New York and New Jersey have banned vaping and e-cigarettes from being used indoors. No word yet if North Carolina might follow their lead.